wanted to make an offer at this point. The lessons are pretty much done, so I thought what else I could do. And so I thought the best thing that I could do was to send prints to actual photographs. And I thought, well, if I made something small enough, it wouldn't cost that much. It'd be easy enough for me to make. Although it's gonna take quite a bit of time. So I thought I'd make an offer. So you can actually send for original black and white prints from me as a reference. So this is a video on how you can get reference prints from me. And this is the size that you'll be getting. Although, if you look at it from like 6 inches away, you can see pretty clearly the information, the detail in what I consider a good technical print. Now, aesthetically, you may not like the images that much, but aside from that point, the blacks, the whites, the local contrast, the detail, it's there, at least from the standpoint of what I consider a good print. So that's what this video is. So if you want to contact me, you can email me and tell me you're interested. Now, in terms of cost, I'm going to be doing the fine prints on real fiber-based paper. It'd be selenium tone, so they'll last a long time, and it's the same paper that I work with. And I'll be offering two images. One will be an image called Wet Fabric, and the other one is the New York Chairs, which I've spoken about in the past. So I have these negatives, and I will be printing from these negatives that I've masked, and only making it this size on 5x7 inch paper. Another thing I'll offer is this image. This is the negative that I shot for my zone system test, which is in my video lesson number four of 14. In that video lesson, I set up a scene in the backyard, and I have all these zones set up. Well, I can make a print of that from the straight print from the negative, and then I'll put the mask on and make another print, so you have a before and after if you want that as well. So in essence, there's four prints if you want everything. One would be 5x7 of the wet fabric, and a 5x7, well, these are 5x7 paper of the New York Chairs, and there's two 5x7s. Now, this is just on RC paper. I don't need to print this on fiber-based paper. That'll save me some time. But the other two images will be on Ilford fiber-based paper. The cost. I researched this, and to be honest with you, most of the interest for these video lessons are overseas. So I had to ship to Hong Kong or Japan or Germany, England. But anyway, the shipping and the packaging, the shipping will cost $15, and a print will only if you want one print, it'll cost $20. So if you want both prints, it'll be $30. And if you want these two, it'd be $35. So the most it'll cost you is $35. And then you can look at these as reference. This is what I consider a good print, that makes masking worthwhile, because let's face it, masking is a lot of work. it's not a lot of work if you consider it fun, right? If you enjoy doing it, then it's okay. But I'm not sure if you're convinced that what I do is worthwhile. So I thought the best thing to do is just to offer real prints. Now, a few years ago, a friend of mine made a CD recording, and someone I knew made a recording, and he says, on the jacket, on a CD jacket, he says, take this to a room, close the door, and listen to the music in a quiet room where you've made time. And you know, he makes the point that too many of us now are listening to music as background music. You know, we're driving, we listen to the CD, and you don't really get a good feeling or a good sense of the composition when you treat music like that. So in an attempt to get people to give his CD the attention that it deserves, he requested that we take it to a room, close the windows, close the door, and listen to it. And it reminded me of when I was a kid. I used to buy a record and sit there in front of the speakers and listen to and read the on the LP, read all the text and listen to the record again and again. And it made the music I purchased when I was a teenager made a big impression on me because I gave it that kind of attention. Now, photographs are everywhere. I mean, and rather than look at what I'm talking about on a computer monitor or on an iPhone, actually hold a photograph and see it. Allow it to have an impression that you otherwise would not have, because it's different. I don't know how many of you are able to go to galleries and look at Edward Weston stuff, or Brett Weston, or Win Bullock, Ansel Adams original prints. But this is an attempt to get something into your hands that will inspire you to learn this and to do it, to carry it on. But anyway, here are the images. Not that my images are great, hold up to those guys. But anyway, here they are here. So on the left is wet fabric. And this is probably shot in 79, 78, maybe 77, pretty early, because I was stepping into the bathtub to take a shower, and my wife had a tub of delicate clothes that she was soaking. And rather than step into it, I went and got my camera, I took a picture of it. So that's the left side, and now that's an early negative shot with a 4x5 speed graphic. I don't remember what film it was, probably Plus S or something. And then on the right, and I've spoken about this image before. This is when I was to New York in 1981. And this was the chairs that were in front of me. I talk about this image at the very end of lesson number 7 of 14. And I expose this for masking. So the image on the left was already shot, and I printed it, and I wasn't happy with it. And when I decided to try masking on negatives, This is one of the negatives I grabbed. I grabbed that and I masked it and I reprinted it. And immediately, the print looked a lot better. It was a lot more similar to how I remember almost stepping into this. It had such nice, luminous tones that I decided to photograph it. Of course, the photograph didn't, I wasn't good enough to actually get that feeling. But after and then I've masked it again over the years, and this is my final attempt And, well, you have to hold it in your hands to see it, to see what I, well, why I like this image and why I did it so many times. I probably masked it 3 or 4 times in the last 30 years. And then this one also, I was able to get the detail, but I wasn't happy with the local contrast, with everything about it, until my masking got better, and I masked it again and again. And but when if you do send for this and you get it into your hands, then you'll be able to look at it closely and see how, you know, I wanted to separate the legs of the chair from each other, and I wanted the top of that chair, the feeling of having been used, people sat on it, how many people have used these chairs and had conversations in them. You know, it was an attempt to try to get that feeling of consciousness left from the usage of these chairs. So anyway, the print now works for me, but it didn't always work in the beginning. But you know, I did it many times. So okay, so here's what I made, so you can look at this. So if you can see this, what I want you to do, if you're interested in this offer, I want you to email me and tell me what it is you want. If you want just the print on the left, the print on the right, or if you want, and if you want this before and after image too. Everything we printed on 5x7-inch paper, that's because it's so expensive, this paper's so expensive. But it'll work. I mean, you'll be able to see. I need you to send me your filled out name and address, because I'm just going to tape it to the back of this cardboard, these cardboard envelopes I'm ordering for this, so I don't have to, I'm not going to make a mistake getting your address correct. I'm going to have to run everything to the post office. I need to tally up what I'm going to print, because I don't want to go in the dark room every time someone orders. This is, you know, it's going to take, I want to do all at once. So today is September 1st, 2017. And a month from now, that means first day of October, I'm going to tally up all the orders. I'll have the paper and the chemistry, and I'll make the prints, and I'll send it out. I really don't want to make 100 each of everything, because it's still a lot of work at 5x7. I don't suspect I'm going to get that many orders, because I don't have that many subscribers and viewers. I haven't heard that much from, haven't gotten that many comments nor emails from people in the last year and a half since I started putting these lessons on. But I wanted to do this, so for 1 month's time, people can order through emailing me. But I'm not going to send it out until I get an envelope from you that has the order sheet, because when you email me, I'll attach a document, you just print it out, and you can write out exactly what you want, and there will be a total you can fill out. You can send me a check, money order, or cash. I don't really care. And when I get your envelope, I'll just take your index card with your name, address on it, put the prints inside this, I don't know, 6x8 envelope, and send it out to you, okay? The address to mail to me eventually would, you know, it'll be in San Francisco. So that's it. I think that's everything I want to say. Again, this is the last thing I can think of that I can do to inspire you, you guys out there who have stuck by me and watched all my videos, all my lessons, to go out and to actually do this. Once you take one of your existing negatives, assuming you get the materials and the equipment, and you do this, the difference that you get from a before and after, like what I have here, will tell you, so all that work is worth it, or is not worth it. Or if I fine-tune, if I make the mask different, if you understand this, then it'll be worth it. Then you can do it and continue this technique, which I don't think that very many people are doing. But anyway, this is what I came up with in order to complete these lessons. The best way is to get these prints into your hands so you can make an evaluation, and then you can decide whether or not you want to venture forth. Once you venture forth and do it, then you'll know even better. Oh yeah, I'll do this only for these kinds of pictures, because you can't do everything. It's too much work. And that's what I do. I just say, well, this is worth working on. Because it's going to take a week or 2 weeks later, and you finally get to the point where you make a print and say, uh-huh. And even then, you might want to do it again. But it's very fulfilling for me. And that's why I spent all the time to make all these lessons, to put it out there. Okay, so, you know, for $35, you can get these four prints and take it or leave it, all these lessons, okay? I think that's it, yeah. So, like, you know, listening to the CD or a record in your bedroom where it's quiet and you give full attention, when you hold a print in your hand, it's different from looking at a print on a monitor. And then especially when you have something to compare it to, you say, oh yeah, now I can see in between this fence and this fence, there's more detail. Do I like that? You know? Okay? Okay. That's it. Thank you.